Hi there! In this video, I wanted to share with you how to create an apple pop art. As you can see, this is a square. You can choose a piece of paper and cut off a piece of it to make it square, divide it into four sections. If you have canvas, you can still use it, but it will just not be a square, it will be rectangular, which is also fine. If you have canvas panels, like squared, you can use those and paint on each of them and then hang them all together next to each other. For this piece, I chose to use acrylic paints. You can choose to draw it and color with color pencils or watercolor pencils, markers, crayons, whichever you like. So now I have four sections, 6x6. And I will draw an apple in each section. And to make sure that they are approximately the same size, I will just use something like a lid, or you can use another circle that something that's on hand to make it approximately the same size. So we'll make an outline. And then from here, we can start drawing an apple. It'll be a little bit thicker. We kind of make it more like oval looking. Then let's make the sides a little bit more off. Then, so these two apples will be whole apples, and these two will be sliced off apples. So we're drawing approximately the same size. Here, cutting off, making the sides a little bit wider. They don't have to be exactly the same form. But this circle, the same size, just will help us to keep them not just like one very small and then another one will be larger, approximately the same size. The form can be different. So now we erase the lines that we don't need. So here, four apples, we may choose to draw these tails. So these two will be sliced off apples. So we need to draw a core. this. So like a very small line. So let's make it. Dividing in half, and then like a circle in the middle with seeds. You can divide the circle into several like slices. Then another one also. And seeds. Like this. So we have now a drawing of four apples, and we will start painting them in like pop art technique. So, using the color scheme, we can choose which colors will go better and pop up and make it very colorful and bright. So, we will use yellow and violet, or then green and red, blue and orange. And you can choose to draw it, to color it with colored pencils or watercolor pencils. And personally, I will do it with acrylic paints. And so we choose red, blue, white, green, and yellow. Now that we have all the paints on the palette ready, we start drawing. So let's make a green apple. So mix green with some yellow. So if you want to make apple look more realistic, make different shades of green. Add a little bit white. And then a little bit darker green. You can add a tiny bit of red to make a different shade of green, a little bit darker. Mix a little bit the shades on the canvas. So we need also to make this hole on the top. We mix a little bit of red with green, and now we have like a brownish purplish color. now by adding the blade here, for example, or make sure that the light is coming from this side. From left upper corner. Not too big, like this. We can add also light green to lighten up that area a little bit more. So this apple will be red apple. We mix a little bit of red with yellow to make it more like warm red color. Oh, you can add also some yellow right on the painting and mix up with red. Mix a little bit of green in red, just a little bit, so you have like a purple color, and add a little bit on the right corner because we have light coming from the left side, so the right will be a little bit more in the shade. Adding the darker color where the supposed to be like a hole. So to add black, we take white paint. And on the left upper corner, make this mark. Yeah. may choose to add some more like marks, like darker red, like some apples have darker lines. Remember that apple is it's a sphere, right? So we have to make sure that when we paint it like sphere on the sides like this, like we're painting a circle. And then if it's closer to the center, then the brush strokes become more straight. Like this. So I'm gonna add some yellow. Next, we will do the inside of the apples. So now we are painting the other two apples, the inside of the apple. The color is a little bit like off to not too white. So we add some yellow to white and tiny bit of red to make it more like orangey color. So I'm painting the inner side of the apple. And we can make the apple yellow. So we mix some yellow with a tiny bit of red. And let's make it so some of the skin, the apple skin, is visible. Thin line of the skin. Then we add a little bit of blue to yellow and a little bit of red, so you have like a dirty yellow color that's for the like inside of the core. If the line gets a little bit too thick, that's okay, because we will be still painting the background. And we can cut the line a little bit later and make it thinner. So we're again painting the inside part of the second apple. Very, very light, pale yellow. Add a little bit of red to make it like warmer yellow. Coming together. A little bit light blicks. So I will be adding a little bit lighter green over here to lighten it up, to lighten the color, because it, when acrylic dries, it gets a little bit darker. So I will make it lighter green. That's a nice green apple. Though I have seen like very, very green, like I painted the first apple. I saw those green apples. They're probably not as tasty though. lighten up a little bit over here. Just a little bit lighter. A little bit like a light blink on the other side of the apple, right here. And then again, adding light. So now, just add a little bit more touches to that apple. So to make brown seeds, we take some yellow with red and green. And we get nice brown color. And we paint a couple of seeds in the center, in the core of the apple. Over here and over here. Now backgrounds. So now we will paint the backgrounds, and for red apple we will choose orange color. Then for yellow, this yellow, we will choose violet or purple. Then for red color we will have green, and here we will have blue background. It will look nicely, like there will be a contrast. So orange, we take red, yellow, mix up, and paint carefully around the apple, slowly cutting off unnecessary brush strokes. Unnecessary lines over here. But everything what's like you can cover the mistake up. Some blue paint, but I like orange. So here's how we do it. Paper towel. So to make the lines straight, you can use masking tape or artist tape. I will just try to make the line as straight as possible without masking tape. Almost perfect. To cover dark green underneath, you will need to put like thicker layer of paint. Make purple, we need red and blue. And you can make it darker like this, or if you want, you can add a little bit more white to color a little bit lighter. Thank you. and when you work around the edge of the apple, just slow down and do it slow so you have a nice line like that. When the paint dries up, you can work better with the line, with the straight line of the cubes, of the square sections. So now we are going to paint the backgrounds of these two apples. This one will be blue and this one will be green. So we take some blue and add white to make it light blue. this background of the fourth square we will do in bright lime green. So we take some yellow with green. Mix it well. And paint carefully around the red apple. If you like any other apples, any other fruits, like pears, bananas, you can always paint or draw other fruits instead of apples. Though bananas will be just yellow color. If you want to make them look more realistic, it will be just green, yellow. Check what other fruits have different colors, maybe pears or grapes. Now we need to finish apples with the tails, or maybe you can add some leaves. So we mix again brown, like greenish brown. Take a thinner brush and draw like a stem here. you add a little bit darker on the right side, a little bit darker brown or purple on the right side of the stem, then you will show like the 3D effect. Like it has the shadow and the light side. Then with some lighter orange and a little like a light bleak on the right, on the left side of the stem. Alright. So next with the, some purple, you can add a little bit dark on the bottom of the two cut in half apples. What else? It's pretty much done. So what you can do also, you can see if you can enhance some of the lines of the apples. Like make it brighter, yellow maybe. I'm enhancing some of the lines, making. You can add some white here, like it's, there's also a bleak. No, you don't have to. It's sometimes it's very like yellowish inside and it doesn't reflect some light, so some bleaks on the seeds. So I'm enhancing a little bit also some like yellow lines in the red apple, making it a little bit different with more of the yellow side, more yellow lines. adding a little bit more red stripes. It looks more like a honeycrisp apple. White blicks also. And we are done. To help hide the imperfections of the brush strokes between the squares, I chose to use gold marker and I draw a border of the whole painting and between each square. You can choose a marker of any color. This is the final piece, and I had a lot of fun creating and sharing it with you. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and healthy, and I will see you soon.